Hi, I'm Ivo. Welcome back to our vlog. We are in Kampala taking some rest after we spent the week with the Danish Refugee Council, traveling and visiting and documenting the work of them and their partners in the refugee settlements in the northwest Uganda, in Adjumani, Arua, and other areas on the border with Congo and South Sudan. Danish Refugee Council has a massive presence here in Uganda. Together with their partners, they work on an eco-funded project addressing some of the basic needs that refugee populations have, such as shelter, water and sanitation, education, and even some of the more innovative ones, such as adult literacy, teaching some basic business skills to the refugees, and enabling them access to credit so they can open up and start and run their own small businesses. For me, one of the highlights of this visit was learning just how welcoming and tolerant the Ugandan society is towards refugees. I think having been refugees themselves in not such a distant past has taught them how important it is to know they're safe. And they are now repaying the favor they received from other countries, now to the refugee populations from South Sudan. We came across signs organizing solidarity runs with the host populations. Uganda stands with refugees is one of the taglines the media use. The media run stories on refugees benefiting local economy. And it's just really refreshing to see a society that's not afraid of being generous and being compassionate, because that's something that we should really look at in Europe when we design our own nationalistic policies and use refugees as scapegoats for political gain. Another highlight that I had was the microcredit schemes that Danish Refugee Council and their partners run in some of the local communities, that very much resembles or is inspired by the work of Muhammad Yunus and the Grameen Bank that he got a Nobel Prize in Economics for, which means a simple small loan from an NGO. So the community starts kind of microcredit groups, and they receive a small loan from an NGO, and then they pass the money on to their members, who then repay the loans with interest, and they can also put the money back into the scheme and earn interest on their earnings. So the refugees themselves were able to start small businesses such as chapati stalls and small shops and arts and crafts, and really get both a viable livelihood here and learn vital business skills that they will be able to use later in their lives when they come back to South Sudan, or even if they decide to stay here for longer. This gives them a real chance to become less dependent on aid and more self-sufficient in running their own lives and earning money. As a filmmaker here, I've learned that the real star here is the drone. Every time the drone comes out, it attracts massive following from both adults and children. And also the footage from it looks stunning. So that, to me, that was really, really enjoyable. They are both beautiful and also very informative. They do show the bigger picture. They really put things in context. Yeah, that's a wrap. Please follow us on our Facebook, on dogoodfilms.org, on Instagram, and on Twitter. That was worse than the first one, wasn't it?
I'm adding that.
Sorry?
Are you done?
Yeah. Good.